2018 is a year that is going to change how we see space forever, and I cannot wait to talk to you about them today. Hey everybody, welcome back to I Need More Space. We're back for, I guess, season two. We had a couple month layoff. I had to basically rip apart most of my basement in my house because we had termite damage and water damage. So here we are, new shop, new set. I don't love the way things are right now, but you know, we're gonna make some improvements as the show goes on, and I just had to make a new video. Before we get started on the big stories right now, I wanna thank a couple of people. One, my brother and sister-in-law for getting me this kick-ass hat, Joe and Katie, thank you. And for my great friends over at Wallops Island at NASA, Tim and Kay, they got me this kick-ass shirt and koozie and astronaut ice cream for Christmas. So thanks a lot, guys. I'm gonna snack on this through the episode. So the first launch we're gonna talk about today is the launch that is gonna be carrying the Arkyd 6A on a rocket out of India. The Arkyd 6A out of Planetary Resources is a CubeSat that is essentially has all kinds of new sensors on board that is designed to help us improve our deep space exploration efforts. And really its main goal is to scan asteroids in our solar system to sense the presence of water. Water is a super important commodity to have in space. We can drink it, we can convert it to oxygen, and in theory we'll be able to convert it into fuel at some point. Oh my God, these things look, it looks like a real ice cream bar. That is really good, oh my God. New Zealand is looking to get into the space race, and this is gonna be with their Electron rocket. They had a test flight in 2017. It got into space, but it did not get into orbit. So they're hoping that in 2018, this rocket is going to achieve lower Earth orbit, and they'll be able to join the rest of the space agencies out there that have the ability to put satellites into orbit. One of my favorite parts about this rocket is that it is all black. It's really sexy for a rocket. It's a little bit smaller, but it's sleek and modern, and you know, I think it's gonna hit really well in a PR effort once it gets going. No, it's really too bad they don't use these in space because they are absolutely tasty. Now, before I go and talk about any of the launches, we need to talk about the Falcon Heavy. This beast is the most powerful rocket that has launched since the Saturn V, which is saying a lot. The plans for this booster system are all over the place. It's gonna be sending humans to the space station, sending humans to the moon, sending humans ideally to Mars, and all just, it's just got an insane payload capacity, and it's really going to accelerate our efforts in low Earth orbit especially. On its first launch, Elon Musk is famously setting up his very first Tesla, and it's going to Mars. And I just cannot wait to see what happens with that, and I hope the launch goes well so we have our first car, not only in space, but set to Mars, which is pretty dope.
Oh my God.
And pending the successful test launch of the Falcon Heavy, Bill Nye's Planetary Society is gonna be sending up its second light sail. What I find really fascinating about the light sail is that it's purely crowdfunded. Its goal is pretty simple. It's still in a lot of the testing phases right now, but essentially it deploys this massive sail once it gets into space, and it uses the sun's rays to propel it through space, and which is just truly the second spacecraft going up that is using something other than liquid propellants in the space, which is just gonna open up all kinds of doors for future space exploration. Now, the last two launches I wanna talk about here are all about the crewed aspect of space flight. Finally, since 2011, coming from the United States. Huge leap for America. Boeing Starliner has two really important test flights coming up. First being the pad abort test in New Mexico, which is scheduled for midway this year. Then by the fourth quarter of this year, they're hoping to have an uncrewed test flight on board the Atlas V. They're gonna take the capsule up, do some maneuvers in low Earth orbit, and then it's gonna come back to Earth, and Boeing's going to retrieve the capsule and make sure it's certified for crewed space flight. Boeing's initial goal was to send up crew by the end of 2018, but I don't see that happening, neither do a lot of other people. It's likely gonna happen first quarter 2019, but it's still a really exciting year for Boeing, and I cannot wait to see how things work out for them. Last but not least, we have SpaceX's Dragon 2 capsule, which is gonna be launching on board the Falcon Heavy, pending, you know, all these other previous flights work out. Let's hope so. The first crewed launch they have planned this year is using a very experienced roster of shuttle and space station astronauts that are just gonna put the capsule through its paces and make sure that it is ready for the show. The four astronauts are gonna be Robert Becken, Eric Bowe, Douglas Hurley, and Sunita Williams. If you've been following NASA for the last decade or two, these are all very familiar faces and super capable of doing this flight. And the final launch we're going to be talking about today is another launch of the Dragon 2. And that is a Dragon 2 that's supposed to go to the moon with three crew on board. Well, I'm suspecting three. Last year, Elon Musk announced that two billionaires purchased rides to the moon. Now, I highly doubt that he's going to send up two people to the moon that have never flown on a spaceship before. So I bet there's going to be at least one experienced astronaut going on that flight. He said it was going to happen at the end of 2018. I highly doubt that this is going to happen by the end of 2018, considering they have a shitload of launches that need to go well this year. So fingers are crossed, but I'm guessing it's going to be first or second quarter 2019. I love the idea. I love the aggressiveness that SpaceX is putting towards their space program. It's getting human spaceflight back into the news cycle again, and I'm just really excited to see what happens. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I do want to dedicate this video to a very special person, and that person being John Young. He flew on Gemini. He flew to the moon twice on Apollo, and he was also the shuttle commander for the very first shuttle flight, STS-1. So this cold one's for you, sir. Thank you very much for everything you did for our country and for human spaceflight. And we'll see you on the other side. Bye, everybody.